हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ राजेश कुमार शर्मा, योर बायोलॉजी टीचर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस इनफर्टिलिटी ऑफ चैप्टर 4, दैट इज रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ। बिफोर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इनफर्टिलिटी, आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू अबाउट योर PA1 एग्जाम, द पैटर्न ऑफ एग्जाम। यू शुड नो, एज यू नो, द सिलेबस इज चैप्टर 1st एंड चैप्टर 2nd, दैट इज रिप्रोडक्शन इन ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स। दीज टू चैप्टर्स विल बी आस्क इन योर PA1 एग्जाम। क्लियर? देर आर 25 क्वेश्चंस इन योर पेपर, दैट विल बी ऑफ 40 मार्क्स, 40 मार्क्स। इन 25 क्वेश्चन देर आर 16 क्वेश्चन ऑफ 1 मार्क्स एंड 7 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ 2 मार्क्स। क्लियर? एंड 2 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ 5 मार्क्स। दिस इज पैटर्न ऑफ योर PA1 एग्जाम पेपर। 16 क्वेश्चन विच आर 1 मार्क्स इज ऑफ MCQ, मल्टीपल चॉइस टाइप क्वेश्चन रहेंगे। क्लियर? 16 क्वेश्चन आपके कैसे रहेंगे MCQ, 7 क्वेश्चन कैसे रहेंगे 2 मार्क्स के और 2 क्वेश्चन 5 मार्क्स के। तो टोटल कितने हो गए, 16 एंड 14, 30 एंड 10, 40। टोटल जो है आपका 40 या 40 मार्क्स का पेपर होगा। क्लियर? एंड ये सारे क्वेश्चन कहाँ से आएंगे, चैप्टर 1st, दैट इज रिप्रोडक्शन इन ऑर्गेनिज्म, एंड चैप्टर 2nd, सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स। क्लियर? नाउ लेट अस फिनिश द चैप्टर रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ। इन दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इनफर्टिलिटी। ये डिस्कशन ऑन रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ इज अनकम्प्लीट विदाउट ए मेंशन ऑफ इनफर्टिलिटी। क्लियर? ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ कपल्स ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड इंक्लूडिंग इंडिया आर इनफर्टाइल, दैट इज दे आर अनेबल टू प्रोड्यूस children in spite of unprotected sexual cohabitation. The reason for this could be many: physical, congenital diseases, drugs, immunological or even psychological effects. Clear? In India, often the female is blamed for the couple being childless. Generally, as in Indian society, generally females are blamed for not having a child. But more often than not, the problem lies in the male partner. Specialized healthcare units, infertility clinics, etc. could help in diagnosis and corrective treatment of some of these disorders and enables these couples to have children. However, where such corrective or corrections are not possible, the couples could be assisted to have children through certain special techniques, commonly known as assisted reproductive technologies, ART. First one, that is in vitro fertilization. In vitro fertilization, what is in vitro fertilization? IVF. In vitro fertilization, fertilization outside the body in almost similar condition as that in the body, followed by embryo transfer, is one of such methods. In this method, popularly known as test tube baby program, ova from the wife or donor female and sperm from the husband or donor male are collected and are induced to form zygote under stimulated condition in the laboratory. The zygote are early embryos with up to 8 blastomeres, could then be transferred into the fallopian tube of female partner. That is called as zygote intrafallopian transfer, ZIFT. And embryos with more than 8 blastomere into the uterus, that is intrauterine transfer, IUT. Means जब जो है 8 ब्लास्टोमियर रहेंगे तब जो है जाइगोट इंट्रा फैलोपियन ट्रांसफर, मीन्स फैलोपियन ट्यूब में इम्प्लांट किया जाता है या ट्रांसफ़र किया जाता है, और जब जो है इम्ब्रियो 8 ब्लास्टोमियर से अधिक, मीन्स अप टू 16 और उससे अधिक हो जाता है, तब जो है डायरेक्टली यूटेरस में ट्रांसफ़र किया जाता है. That is called as intrauterine transfer. To complete its further development, embryos formed by in vivo fertilization, fusion of gametes within the female also could be used for such transfer to assist those females who cannot conceive. Next one, transfer of an ovum collected from a donor into the fallopian tube, GIFT, gamete intrafallopian transfer, of another female who cannot produce one. Means ऐसे female जिनमें जो है एक या ovum produce नहीं होता है, उनमें directly जो है ovum fallopian tube में transfer किया जाता है, ठीक, but can provide suitable environment for fertilization and further development is another method attempted. Intracytoplasmic sperm injection is another specialized procedure to form an embryo in the laboratory, in which a sperm is directly injected into the ovum. Infertility cases, either due to inability of male partner to inseminate the female or due to very low sperm count in the ejaculation, could be corrected by artificial insemination technique. In this technique, the semen collected either from the husband or a healthy donor is artificially introduced either into the vagina or into the uterine or uterus. That is called intrauterine insemination of the female. Though options are many, all these techniques require extremely high precision handling by specialized professionals and expensive instrumentation. Therefore, these facilities are presently available only in very few centers in the country. Obviously, their benefits is affordable to only a limited number of people. Emotional, religious, and social factors are also deterrent in the adaptation of these methods. Since the ultimate aim of all these procedures is to have children, in India we have so many orphaned and destitute children who would probably not survive till maturity unless taken care of. Our law permits legal adoption, and it is as at one of the best methods for couples looking for the parenthood. This chapter has been finished. We will start next chapter in our next lecture. Okay. Thank you.